Jean Davenport's Cosmic Shimmer Star Power Inks have arrived at long last. In today's video, I'll experiment and create with them to see how I can add color and shimmer using my dip and dab technique to create backgrounds with them, and I can even color with them. We have them on introductory sale where you'll save 20% on the entire color range. Links to the products can be found in the expanded description below. There are 16 colors in Jane's Star Power line. They're essentially liquid watercolors with mica in them, and they're great for all kinds of techniques. You can use them alone, you can use them with water, you can intermix the colors for a larger palette. The inks are really vivid and the colors are intense, and the mica just makes them that much more special. So like anything with mica in it, it's going to sink to the bottom of the bottle. Let me get this moving. You can hear the mixing ball in there starting to move around, and that's important because if I hold this up, you can see that there's still mica on the bottom of the bottle. But if I shake this enough and I get this color, or I get the mica up and distributed in the liquid, you can see that the bulk of that is now off the bottom, and I would just continue to shake this. So inside, let's slide all of this out of the way. Let's knock some of the bottles over while we do it. And before I actually do this, I swatch them all, so I always like to see what this stuff looks like before I start playing with it for making a project. I mean, part of the play process is to go ahead and create these swatches. So I'm going to continue to shake this, and what you'll notice is now that the mica is all up and off the bottom of the bottle, see this little button? That's how you go ahead and fill the pipette that's built into this. So I can go ahead and fill that up, which it is now, and I can just drop this on here. And this is pretty, but it gets even better because I'm going to add some water to it. And this is where I love to play with liquid watercolors, because now I've got this movement that happens, and if I pick this up and I start to let gravity kind of have its way, I can cause this to run and drip and kind of do all kinds of fun things. Or I could simply put this down and let it dry the way it is. I like this kind of spattering effect that's going on here. Now, even if this were dry, I could come back and I could add water to it, because these are re-wettable as watercolors. So they're going to work on all kinds of pore surfaces. This is one of our number 8 watercolor tags, but I want to show you that you can use them. Alright, let's get that out of there. Let's just kind of wipe that off. That's the same color. This happens to be Veronica. You can use them on all pore surfaces. Obviously on black, the color is going to look a little bit different than it will on the wet cement or the craft, but the beauty of these is there's enough mica in them and there's enough pigment in them that they're going to give you color on virtually anything, even if it's only the mica that you see on black, which, because these are a dye-based product, to some extent that's going to happen. But you can play with these in lots of different ways. Now, this is the color pretty much straight from the bottle with only a little bit of water. Here's color where I added a little bit more water. This is one where I just went ahead and put the water on and added the color to it and moved it around with a brush. So, and then here's one, you can tape the edges of these off if you want to create kind of a frame-like effect. So let's go ahead and let's spray some water on here. Let's pick two colors. So I have Jane and Claudette. This was Veronica, by the way. I'm gonna go ahead and give them a shake, and while I'm doing that, well, maybe I'm gonna not do two things at once. I'm gonna go ahead and put some water on this tag. So obviously I'm working on white here, so there's not going to be any change in color other than when they start to mix together. But you can see how easy this is to do this. Let's go ahead and give this a shake. Now the mica is much more visible once the color dries. And if I want to bring in a brush, which I generally want to do, I can put some water down here. Let's grab a brush with a little bit bigger bristles on it. I can go ahead and I can start moving this around. Now I can move this really gently. I could start spreading this around. I kind of like this look, so I might leave that alone. Or you know what, just let's go for the gusto and let's kind of just spread this out. So you can really get these colors to intermix, which is how you're going to end up with a larger palette. Or you can kind of leave them in discrete areas like they are here. The other thing that you can do that I think is pretty interesting, let's just go ahead and clean that out. And you really can't see, like I said, when the color's wet, you really can't see the sparkle, but let me just take the swatches for a second, and you can see how much they reflect in the light. So this stuff is full of mica, it's full of color, and they really are fun to play with. So something that you can do that I think is kind of interesting is you can use that built-in pipette, however you want to pronounce it. Let's grab a different color. I know there's a purple in here. Let's go ahead and grab, this is Josephine. And I think I'll come back and I'll use it with the turquoise. So one of the things that you can do is use that pipette as kind of your motion activator, if you will. I have used this really successfully. You can get kind of these spiky shapes going on here if you want. It's a little harder to do. Oops, good grief. Well, we now have Josephine all over the place, or whoever this is, I've kind of lost track. But you can see what happens. I have the ability with this, I could do this with the back of the brush too, but the nice thing is that there's paint or there's watercolor in here, so I can't believe I just did that. I'm just going to move along here and we'll ignore that. But you can see when you work with the pipette, you can use it as an applicator and you can use it to direct the color. So I'm going to clean this up and then I'm going to come back, and if I really wanted to make this move, I could add some water and that's when it would really start to move. So I'm going to come back in a second, and after I clean up, I'm going to show you how I work with my normal dip and dab technique, which I like a lot, and then I'm going to combine the Star Power inks with oxide sprays, and then I'm going to show you how you can stamp an image and go ahead and color with the Star Power inks. These are the samples I created in the last segment, and I did want to show them to you before I move on to dip and dab with oxides and Star Power inks. So this is just Veronica, where I put it down, I spritz some water, and I kind of let it do its thing. This is a combination of Claudette and the infamous Jane that I shook all over the place in the last segment. And again, you can see all the glimmer that's going on in there and the blending of colors. And then finally, this was Jane, and in this case, it was mixed with Josephine. Now, the thing worth noting here, you can see all the sparkle in there. But the thing worth noting too is that moving the color around with the pipette causes there to be scratches on the surface, which I think is fine. It's just an additional layer of texture, but that's something that you should probably be aware of. So now let's move on to dip and dab, and I have a couple of samples to show you. So these were done earlier, and off the top of my head, I don't remember all the colors that I used, but when I hold these up to the light, let's see where we are here. If I hold these up to the light, you can see the glimmer that's going on in there. Now, obviously, it's been diluted a little bit because I've added water and because there are oxide sprays, but you can certainly see it in there. Now, the thing to do is to add less water, which let's try it this time. So I have two colors of oxide sprays. I have picked raspberry and squeezed lemonade, and because they're probably going to make some blend of an orange, I'm bringing in the Star Power ink that's named Ginger because it's kind of that color. So I need to give all of these a shake, and I'm going to work on, again, watercolor surfaces. I have a 5x7 index card and a number 8 tag. All right, so let's just go ahead and give this a little bit more of a shake. All right, you can see that the color and the mica is all up and moving in the liquid. So I'm going to put out some of both of these colors. Now, ordinarily, I would add water when I'm doing dip and dab like this, so I'm going to do that. But now I'm going to come in and I'm going to add the ginger color, or the Star Power color named Ginger, to what I've got going on here. And I'm going to be pretty liberal with it. I mean, it's the holidays, so why not sparkle, right? I mean, that's kind of my feeling. So dip and dab, it's the same thing that you've seen me do countless times, and I'm going to need to take a second in a moment to get this stuff to dry. And you can see that the orange is very predominant because I put so much of that down. So what I'm going to do is come back and let's add a little bit more squeezed lemonade. I don't even think I need to add any more water to that. I'm just going to come and sort of think about where I'm putting the color, or where I'm putting the tag in which puddle of color. And you can see that I've got plenty going on, but I'm feeling like I need a little bit more picked raspberry in here so we can go and dip and dab a little bit. So I'm going to take a moment I'm going to dry these, and in fact, I can already see the glimmer starting. Let me take these over to the side, and I'll dry them, and then I'll come back and I'll add the next layer, because if one layer is good, and I find that it is with Dip and Dab, two layers is always better, and sometimes a third is even warranted. So the index card and the tag are dry enough for me to come back and add the second layer. They're certainly not completely dry. And I did put a little bit more picked raspberry down because, again, I felt like I had kind of lost some of that. Oh, how pretty is that? See, now I've got color on top of color. And this is kind of the joy of Dip and Dab, is it allows you to really get those layers going on there. So I'm going to put that to one side. I think I'm probably willing to call that one done. And let's go ahead and see what we get. We just randomly kind of dip this. Now this one is a little bit more orange, but nothing says that I can't if I want. Let's go ahead and wipe this up. Nothing says that if I want, I can't come back and take the pickup tube and go ahead and I can add some pink this way. That allows me to control what I'm doing a little bit more. Now the plan was, is I was going to move right on to showing you some ways that you can color with Star Power inks, but given the mess that my hands are and the mess that the table is, I'm going to take a second, I'm going to clean this up, and then I'll come back and I'm going to show you how you can use, let me grab these, how you can use Marlene's, this is her Guardian, whoops, let's kill the glare, it's her Guardian Angel set from the 2022 Christmas release, and whoops, and these little pre-cut flags that are used to go ahead and stamp this on. So I've played with this, and I have another thing that I've played with. Let me clean up, and I'll be back in just one second. Coming back to the Guardian Angel stamp that was released as part of the Art by Marlene 2022 Christmas collection, there was this smaller version with the appropriately sized flags, and then there was a much bigger version that actually had mix and match parts in it, and there was a bigger version of this that fit that. So water is where I'm going here because it's what I use, and I think it works really well because it creates that wicking and blending. And if you just let the ink follow the water, it pretty much, as long as you're careful where you put the water, it pretty much goes where it's supposed to. So I've got three that I did here. This one, I wet it, and you can just see there's some of the Catherine color on there, so there's a lot of silver on here. This one, I put the color on first, and then I stamped over it once it was dry. And here, I let the bleeding and the wicking happen a little bit more. And then this one, I colored more like it was something with intent, I guess is the way to say it. Because you can see that there are areas where I haven't left any color, and I was kind of specific about what I did. So I'm going to come back to this one because I think she needs a little bit of interest to add to what she's already got going on. And what I'm going to do is put some water down. And because I'm already covered in this color, and it works with silver, I'm going to come back and add some of that color. So I need to get this shaken up, put a little bit of the color out, and I'm going to put the cover back on this time. That should be more than enough. And I'm just going to add some of this color to the angel. So yes, the color that's already on here, although it is very light, will begin to wick and move around because I'm adding water to it. And I can already see, you probably can't, but I can already see some of the mica in the water that's on the table. And that's fine. I don't care about that one way or the other. It all is going to end up fine at the end of the day. So this is a pretty intense color, as you can tell by my hands. So I want to water it down a little bit so I don't overwhelm this. And I'm just going to go ahead and kind of let the water do its thing and just add some of this. Now, I probably will add this all over because if I don't, it's gonna, I think, look a little bit odd. So I'm just gonna come in and spread it around. And if I wanted to, I could bring the silver back. And in fact, let's do that. Where is the silver? It's the one that's named Catherine that appears to be hiding. Is that, this is it. So let's just go ahead and give this a shake. Get that color up. And get the mica rather up and moving off the bottom of the bottle and put a little bit out here and then pick this up. And I can come in and I can start to wash some more of the silver in so that it doesn't get so lost in the blue. And this is, I mean, it's pretty simple. This is a very easy process. The kids can have a lot of fun with this. They can be successful with it. None of this has to be perfect, which makes life so much simpler. So again, here's one where I've just kind of washed some color on. All right, so let's clean this up, and then I want to show you one last thing. When you color, you can be far more specific than I was certainly there. And again, I'm going to just spritz this to clean up any extra color. So I have another of Marlene's stamps. It's Marlene and Jane Playday, evidently. So this is the stamp set that's named Mix and Match Dotty Flowers, and I used this on the back as inspiration for how I went and stamped this. And I have a reasonably small brush here, and I'm going to put some more water out, and I'm going to grab two colors. I have, what do I have here? This is Doris and Rita. And what I'm going to do is come in and work on this flower here, the big one in the center. Now, I'm not going to do the whole thing because you don't need to see me do the whole thing, but you'll get an idea of how this works. And you know what? I might put out a little bit of the Veronica. Actually, I take that back. Let's put some of the ginger back out because I think that that's going to work. I'm going to come back to the let's wet it first process because, again, I find that the color follows the water and it's much simpler to get the look that I'm aiming for. So I think that might be a little bit too much water. But all I'm going to do is pick up some of the yellow and I'm going to dot it in there and let it more or less follow the color. So same thing, since I'm going to work with yellow again, and we're going to ignore the fact that I got pink where I didn't want it to be. Because I'm going to work with yellow again, I'm not too worried about really cleaning out the brush. And I'm staying away from that center because it's going to take a little while for that to dry. So I'm just kind of carefully going along and I'm putting water where I know I'm going to want this yellow color. And if it dries up a little bit, I can always come back and add some more. So now I'm going to pick up my color and I'm just going to start touching it. And again, you let the water do the work and the color pretty much, as long as you were careful about where you put the water, the color pretty much does its own thing and it follows the water. Now up here, I'll get a little bit of blending because this obviously will re-wet and the yellow will mix with a little bit of the pink, but I'm okay with that. I don't really mind. So I want to stay away from the center and I want to stay away from this yellow that I just did, because if I don't, then I'll get color bleeding because, of course, that's what the water is going to do. So let's come down and I will work on, you know what, I can actually work in the center. I'm going to come back, let's put some fresh water down that doesn't have too much yellow in it. I'm going to come back and I'm going to work in this area in here. And I'm going to use, well, okay, so that didn't work out quite the way that I had planned. Ordinarily, I would have dried this beforehand, but that's okay. I can make this work because I'm going to work with the ginger color anyway, and this will all blend together and it'll be fine at the end of the day. All right, so what did I do with it? Here it is. Okay. Now, you know what? I already put that color down. I really have lost my mind here. I have to tell you, I was so flabbergasted when I shook that bottle and the color went everywhere. I'm completely, totally turned around by that. So I'm putting the color more in the center like this. And because I've already got yellow out there, I might as well take advantage of what's out there. So let's clean this off. So I'm working with really just a wet brush. And then I'm going to encourage this color to kind of flow outward. But, you know, I kind of have a lemon here, so I'm going to make lemonade from it. Let's pick up just a little bit of yellow and put it in here. And again, the magic of this kind of stuff is that the water really does so much of the work for you. And that's as far as I'm going to go because too much of it is wet for me to effectively do anything else, and I don't want to screw this up because I really do kind of like it. Well, I don't kind of like it. I definitely do like it. So these are Jane Davenport's Star Power inks. There are, what did I say in the beginning, 16 colors. I've lost my mind here at this point. I'm still so flabbergasted that I shook that bottle all over the place. But these are Jane's Star Power inks, 16 colors. We've got them in stock here at the warehouse at joggles.com, and you save 20% across the board on all of them.